Alright, this is going to be a really exciting video. Sorry you can't see me. About Rubik's Cubes, because I just got this new one, the Megaminx, in the mail. It has 12 sides, blah, 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 and it turns like so. And it clicks into place. Alright. But anyway, the main reason I wanted to make this is because it came in this packaging right here. And, you can't see it, but it says Chinese Magic Ball. Here, let me read you the description for the Chinese Magic Ball. The playing way of Chinese Magic Ball is similar to that of Mofang. When playing, move the fixing pieces of one side around the central 5-argled piece. Then move the fixing pieces of another side and change its position. When you go on moving this way, you can get any two sides opposite each other. After this, the fixing pieces of the same color of the 12 sides get into different positions, turning every side one time. When it is 18 times, the ball turns out such complicated changes that you can hardly turn the fixing pieces of the same color back to their original positions. Would you think you can manage it? Please make a try. And English makes me laugh so hard. Alright, just a quick rundown on my other cubes. So that's the Megaminx. I have the East Sheen 2x2, East Sheen 4x4, and V Cube 5x5, and of course my makeshift Void Cube. My mirror box cube, which in case you guys don't know, basically when you turn it, it makes different shapes, and you have to solve it based on the shape of all the pieces. That's all fun and games, but, I've misplaced my regular Rubik's Cube, but whatever. The East Sheen 4x4 also came in such packaging, and it's also made in China, and it has some funny English on it also. So let me see if I can find it. Oh. Warning! Avoiding to put any parts into mouth or choke on. And don't dismantle cube by force. Oh. Brain Tempest. Challenge your patience. Don't worry, mess up a cube, dismantle it, and try again. It is available you to do it yourself, waiting you to dismantle and assemble. This is actually from Taiwan. It just makes me laugh that all of these cubes come from other countries, because apparently Americans are too dumb to make Rubik's Cubes. But yeah, that's my collection. And 2x2 is freaking awesome. And this is freaking awesome, but it's hard. And it's kind of annoying. I do like this cube, but the pieces are so sharp that you often get things like that where it like starts to pop when you move it. You have to be really careful when you move it. And you can literally just like pull pieces out like nothing else. And those little slots right there are why it clicks into place. You can see. Oh my goodness, hold on. Alright. You can see. Can you see the little bump right there? Right there. Yeah. That's what clicks into those places, and that's why it clicks into place. It's made like that to try and prevent popping out. Doesn't work completely, but whatever. It's a fun puzzle. It's basically just like the 3x3 with a ton more pieces. Like, you solve it the same way. I use some Friedrich F2L, which you do F2L like 5 times, and then last layer's the same. Just has an extra like centerpiece. You see there are 5 centerpieces. So if you're thinking about getting one of these cubes, get it. 5x5 is my favorite so far, because it's my favorite, and I like the 2x2. I hate the 4x4 because of stupid parodies, oh my goodness. And the Void Cube's cool. Alright,